Gully.
Thank you, Mr. Gray. It's a pleasure to serve under your chairmanship. As a London MP, along with many here on both sides of the House have campaigned to protect police funding across London. And it's right that MPs continue to do so. It's right that Assembly members continue to do so in London as well. And it's right that the Mayor is a leading voice in that. But however, the Mayor needs to, as we've heard, make sure that his choices, his discretionary choices in his budget, match up to his rhetoric and his ask of central government. He has, as we've heard, choices that he can make in other budgets. He has significant usable reserves as well. He removed £38 million from the budget this year, which is roughly pretty well equivalent to the amount that would be needed to bring the police numbers up to the 32,000 target that he has. The previous mayor, the honourable friend for Uxbridge and South Ruislip, had identified a funding gap a good few years ago, and he'd been campaigning on that as well, and had also been planning for it. The Met has been planning since 2015, and I'm sure if the roles were reversed, Labour would be on the attack for that mayor as well, rather than looking at central government. Now, we've heard about the uptick in knife crime, in gun crime, in a situation with a similar financial background to what had gone under the previous mayor. And we've also heard about new types of crime and proliferation of those crimes, acid and, attacks and moped crime, which I won't go into any more detail because others have already. I have a concern with the proposed station closures as well, but actually partly from operational reasons. Worcester Park has a shopfront, as we heard from the Honourable Member for Romford. My concern is actually the travel times for safer neighbourhood teams to actually have to come out of central Sutton to get to their wards, their areas, actually being included in their shift times, which because they have a centralised meeting, which actually takes time out of their time on the beat. Which is of concern. We've heard a little bit about three borough mergers, and again, I've got a particular concern with that in Sutton, because Sutton is being looked at with Croydon and Bromley. And having a linear settlement like that will really have a huge effect on response times, in my opinion. We know how difficult it is to get across London as opposed to in and out. And I'll just conclude with the with things that I've talked about. And I noticed early on in the debate the Honourable Member for Halifax was here, and I commend her for her work on police safety. I'd called in a debate earlier that she had about the use of spit guards and the equipment that that police need. And I really don't want to be seeing the funding issues meaning that police are unable to have the equipment that they need to do the job properly. The Mayor of London is no longer a lawyer representing people claiming against the police. He's representing Londoners, he's representing victims of crime and potential victims of crime, and it's really important, and he's representing those police that actually are on the front line. It's really important that we support them. So can I just finally finish with paying tribute and saying thank you to Sutton Police, who provide a fantastic service and keep Sutton as one of the safest boroughs in London.
Very briefly, Sir Ed Davey.